interesting.
Yes.
It wouldn't raise your alarm level at all.
I would want to know why. But if you're asking me if just that alone made it suspicious, no.
Yes, I am.
No.
Okay. How about we add on the fact that the apartment where she let officers was empty? Is that suspicious?
I was curious as to why that would be. Obviously, I wasn't with them when she showed the apartment, so perhaps she pointed out the wrong apartment or they got it wrong. I don't know. I wasn't part of that yet, so I was relying on what other deputies had told me.
My question to you, Detective, is the fact that she showed officers an apartment that was vacant, where she said she dropped the babysitter off, that wasn't suspicious to you?
If you define what you mean by suspicious, maybe I'll be able to say yes or no. I'd find it interesting, the whole story that she told. But if you're trying to make me say I just found it suspicious without you telling me what you believe the definitions to be, then maybe I can help with that.
I'm not trying to make you say anything. I'm asking you simple questions, and I'll see if I can rephrase them to assist you.
Thank you.
Now, what about those two facts coupled together? Does that make it just a little bit more than interesting?
No, the whole situation was interesting. I was walking into it, and okay, without having talked to her myself, I was just being given the preliminaries. Obviously, I was interested, and I wanted to find out what was going on, and I wanted to find out more. That's why I ultimately questioned her.
Now, aside from those two facts, if I can get her statement back.
Of course.
You didn't find this suspicious at all, the contents of what was in here.
Are you asking about something specific in there or just the whole thing?
Her statement to law enforcement. You didn't find that suspicious?
Not at the time, no.
Okay, do you recall writing a report on this case?
Yes.
May I approach the witness?
You may.
I'm going to show you defense exhibit A.
Thank you.
On page 104, the third paragraph down, after it says she said it was,
mm-hmm,
can you read to the court that sentence?
I told her that the incident was very suspicious and her version suspect.
You care to change your previous answers now?
Your Honor, I'm going to object to his argumentative comment.
Overruled?
No. Well, what I told her and what I felt or thought at the time, I told her it was suspicious.
So on July 16th, when you wrote this report, it was suspicious, but today it's not?
No. I told her it was suspicious, but you're asking me if I thought it was. I was interested in what was going on.
So you lied to her?
Yes.
Okay. You're not lying today?
No.
Okay. Now, when you arrived, you then began to question her, did you not?
Yes.
You separated her from the rest of her family?
Yes.
And then you confronted her with her statement?
I talked to her about her statement, and I got another one on tape.
Okay. But you confronted her with it, right? You showed it to her?
Yeah, I asked her if it was correct and what she had written was true, and she affirmed it and said yes.
And you gave her an opportunity to admit that what she had written here was a lie?
Yes.
Okay. Which, of course, would have been a crime.
It could have been.
Okay. Now, after or before that, did you Mirandize her?
No.
Okay. And you had her in her room?
No, she was in the, I want to say it's the spare bedroom that they have in the house.
It was in a bedroom?
Yes.
And you were alone?
Yes.
With a female suspect?
Yes. Well, no, hold on. You're saying a suspect. She's not a suspect. I was alone with the mother of a missing child.
You said yes, did you not? You just
no.
want to change your answer?
Yes, I want to change my answer.
Okay.
She was not a suspect. She was
all
a mother of a missing child.
All right. Not a Freudian slip or anything, right? All right. Now, you then questioned her about it, and she did not change her story.
Correct.
And you tape recorded her?
I did.
And she was aware she was being tape recorded?
Yes.
Okay. And on this recording, which you would use for later on, would you not? Yes. You were recording it to memorialize your conversation?
Yes.
To possibly show one day a judge?
I was recording it to memorialize the situation where it would end up being shown in a future date I wasn't thinking about at the time.
Which possibly might end up in front of a judge.
It could, yes.
And possibly might end up in front of a jury.
Yes, obviously it has.
Okay. Now, you didn't Mirandize her during this conversation as well?
I did not.
Okay. Now, when you, after questioning her, you then asked her to go with you to look for where she had dropped off Zenaida.
I asked her if she would show me.
Excuse me, Kaylee.
I asked her if she would show me the places where Zenaida used to live and where she used to drop off Kaylee.
Okay. And this is the same exact place that she took the previous officers?
She took me. Well, I wasn't with the previous officers, so I can only assume it was the same place. But I took her to, you're talking about Sawgrass?
Yes.
And she pointed out an apartment to me.
But when you arrived, detectives actually, or Sergeant Hosey actually debriefed you, didn't
he? Yes.
In fact, that's the first thing you do when you arrive on scene, right? Get a debriefing?
Yes.
Okay. So he had told you that they had already taken her in the back of a police car to Sawgrass Apartments.
Yes.
But he neglected to tell you that they handcuffed her.
I did not know she was handcuffed at all.
Okay. Is today the first time you're hearing about it?
No, it is not.
When was the first time you heard about it?
About a few months ago, after the deposition of, I think it was Deputy Ryan Eberling. That was the first I heard about it.
You weren't present during this deposition.
No.
So how did you find out about it?
I found out about it after the fact.
From whom?
The state attorney.
Okay. And did you not get Casey Anthony's phone records?
Yes.
And you obviously checked all of her phone records?
I checked her phone records, yes.
You checked the phone records of her boyfriend, Tony Lazaro?
Yes.
You checked the phone records of all of her friends?
Several of her friends, yes.
Did you see the text where Casey told Tony Lazaro that she was in handcuffs?
I don't recall that text.
Okay. You don't recall it?
I don't.
Or you did not see it?
I don't recall seeing it.
Okay. Now, approximately what time in the morning are you taking Casey Anthony in your car?
It was shortly after my recorded statement with her, so I'd have to guess about 4:30 in the morning.
And is she in a unmarked patrol car?
Yes.
Okay. And are there any other officers with you?
Not in the car, no. There was one in a marked patrol vehicle that followed us along as we went.
Okay. And why did he follow?
In case I needed to make contact with anyone, I wanted a marked car and a uniform present.
Kind of like backup?
Yes.
Now, you took her first to Sawgrass Apartments?
No. I believe she led me to the places. So, although I was driving, she told me where to go. I believe the first was 301 Hillside, the seniors-only facility near Glenwood, Bumby, that area.
Now, you knew when she took you there that responding officers had found a note in her car from an address that was nearby, right, across the street?
I knew about the note, but I can't remember when I was given the note. I presume it was before I left the house, and there was a 232 Glenwood address on the note.
And you found that suspicious?
I honestly wasn't thinking about the note at all while she was driving me around. After the fact, obviously, I wondered why she wouldn't tell us about 232 Glenwood. But I don't remember an independent thought about that as we're driving through the seniors or the 301 Hillside Avenue.
So the first place she took you to was the seniors only home?
Yes.
And then you went and knocked on doors?
No.
The backup patrolman knocked on some doors?
What doors are you referring to?
At the old folks' home?
No.
Okay. How did you find out that it was a seniors-only facility?
After the fact, after everything was said and done and I went to the different locations, I ended up going back to the seniors-only facility.
Okay. Then, after that, where did you take her?
She led me to the Sawgrass Apartments, where she indicated and pointed out the apartment.
And what did you do there?
We just drove through the parking lot. She pointed out the apartment, and then we went to the next place.
You didn't knock on any doors?
No.
Take a look?
No.
Okay. Where'd you go after that?
She led me a catty corner to, I think it's Crossings at Conway, a series of single-story apartments or townhomes.
Knocked on some doors there?
Yes.
Okay. And this is like 4 o'clock in the morning?
No, now it's daylight's coming up, so maybe about 6 o'clock or so.
Okay. So Casey Anthony is with you or at your side from about 3:30 till what time?
Approximately 6 or 7 when I dropped her off.
Yeah. Did any time throughout that process you Mirandize Casey?
No.
Then you dropped her off home at what time?
Again, I want to say it's between 6 or 7 in the morning.
And when you arrived, did Mr. Anthony pull you aside?
I remember speaking to Mr. Anthony in the driveway. He actually walked up to the open passenger window of my car after Casey had left.
And what did he tell you?
I could refer to my report for the...
Yes, please. Please do.
You want to read it verbatim or just a bridge?
No, just if you can use it to refresh your recollection.
He was concerned that Casey was holding back information and that he and his wife thought that something may have happened with Kaylee.
Now, at this point, you've got to be suspicious, right?
Again, give me a definition of suspicious.
Is she a suspect?
No, she's not a suspect in the crime, no.
Okay. So the child's missing for 30 days. She's giving you information that's not correct. Her own father comes and tells you she's holding back information. And she's still not a suspect to you.
What information did she give me that wasn't correct?
The fact that she dropped her off at a location and that place was no one was there.
I didn't determine that to be correct or incorrect at the point.
Okay. What about the fact that she hadn't reported the child missing for 30 days? Was all of that, the entire scenario that she'd been through, and that she had said a location of where Zenaida had lived was a seniors only facility, none of that resonated with you?
At what point are you asking me did I find it suspicious? Because at the time I dropped her off, I didn't know that it was a seniors only facility.
I'll make it easy on you. At any point in that evening, did you see or sense that what was going on with your investigation and Casey Anthony was suspicious?
I wouldn't say it was suspicious. Again, I would say I was curious about it. I hadn't determined whether or not it was a senior facility. I hadn't checked up on Sawgrass yet.
Okay. Now, after you drop off Casey Anthony and after you get this information from Mr. Anthony, you then start doing some investigating.
Yes.
And then you go to Sawgrass Apartments.
Yes.
And you find out that that apartment has been vacant for how long?
142 days.
Okay. Now it's suspicious?
Yes. Now I'm starting to wonder
what's
going on.
And then after that, what else do you do?
Inevitably, I went to Universal Studios.
Prior to that, you briefed your Sergeant Allen, did you not?
Prior to going to Sawgrass, yes.
You guys had breakfast. You talked about the case.
Well, we talked about the call that morning, yes.
Okay. Then you said, I'm going to Universal Studios.
Yes.
Okay. And this was to find what?
A couple of things. Casey had told me that a couple of the roommates, or a couple of the friends that she had talked to about Kaylee gone missing, worked at Universal Studios, or had worked. She also said that Zenaida was a temporary employee or seasonal employee and had an ID card from there. So she's giving me addresses for Zenaida. I want to find out who the outcry witnesses are and where they live. So going to Universal was to try and find out who they were, where they lived, and talk to them about Kaylee and about Zenaida and about what Casey would have told them.
So you arrive there and things get even more suspicious, do they not?
They get more curious, yes.
Okay, but not suspicious.
Well, ultimately, yes.
All right. Now you find out that Casey Anthony was fired 2 years prior.
She was fired in 2006, yes.
Okay. And you find out that the only Jeff Hopkins that was there that would have been an alleged cry-out witness was fired in 2002.
Yes.
Okay. And you pretty much know that she's lying now that she doesn't work at Universal Studios.
She had claimed to work at Universal. I know they have a lot of subcontractors that work there. I couldn't fathom that the mother of a missing 2.5-year-old child would have lied to me about working at Universal, both in writing and in a verbal statement. So maybe I got it wrong. Maybe she worked off-site and she was a subcontractor that wouldn't have a Universal ID.
Did she ever utter the words, I work off-site at Universal Studios?
No.
Okay, so that was an assumption you were making?
Yes.